We now take the case of application of the inverse operator 1 over FD to x. X is a function of x when this function is specifically a polynomial function involving integral powers of x. I have taken an example. Let us try to solve this equation. D square minus 3d plus 2 y is equal to x square plus 3. We again recall that this process of applying 1 over fd to x, in this particular case x is x square plus 3, will result in a particular integral. And we remind ourselves that any differential equation has two parts to the solution. One is called the complementary function, the other is called the particular integral, and the solution, total solution, the complete solution is given by y is equal to y complementary plus y particular. Now, in this particular case, the complementary function is very easy to write. We will do that in just a minute. Complementary function results by setting the right hand side to 0, and there will be an auxiliary equation. That auxiliary equation by inspection here is, if you write auxiliary equation, is m square minus 3m plus 2 is equal to 0, whose roots are m is equal to 1 and m is equal to 2. So the complementary function is c1 e to the power of 1x plus c2 e to the power of 2x, because these two roots are distinct and real. So yc can be written as c1 e to the power of x plus c2 e to the power of 2x. It has as many independent arbitrary constants as the order of the equation, which is 2. Now we will concentrate more on the particular integral, and we will see what is the process when the expression on the right, the function on the right, that is the capital X function, is a polynomial. So, in this particular case, we have taken the x function to be a polynomial function and taken x square plus 3 to be the expression for the polynomial. And evidently, therefore, y particular is equal to 1 upon d square minus 3d plus 2 applied on x square plus 3. That is what we wish to find. Now, the process is, we will try and see if we can write 1 over d square minus 3d plus 2 in terms of a power series in D. That means the result will be a power series preceding this x square plus 3, and that is done by using the binomial theorem. So we write this as 1 over 2, 1 plus d squared minus 3d by 2 applied on x squared plus 3. Now, how do we expand this expression on the preceding x squared plus 3 as a power series of d, because we will see that all the d's reside in the denominator of this. The process is to treat this as 1x. or alpha, because we are using x as the independent variable. So we will try and see what is the expansion of 1 over 1 plus alpha in terms of the binomial series, and we know that it is actually equal to 1 minus alpha plus alpha square minus alpha cubed and so on. Similarly, 1 over 1 minus alpha is 1 plus alpha square plus alpha cubed and so on. These are two important series, and they will actually converge when alpha has a value such that it is between minus 1 and plus 1. In other words, the mod of alpha should be less than 1. But that is unimportant. Here, we use a little bit of, you know, brawn to say that yes, we will see, or we will assume that the binomial theorem application, this application, can be given also to expressions of this form where there is no alpha, but alpha is in terms of d. So we will use that force shear body power to see what happens. Ultimately, if we get a result that is tenable, then our assumption is not at least wrong. That is what we can conclude. We will do this expansion a little on top so that we get a bit of extra space. So this is equal to the half resides outside, 1 plus alpha to the power of minus 1 is first 1 minus alpha. So 1 minus d square minus 3d by 2 plus alpha square. So plus d square minus 3d whole square by 4 minus the cube of this, so that would be 1 by 8. There will be a term, in the cube term there will be a d to the power of 6. Now mind you, what we have on the right is that we have to apply all this on a fellow who is called x square plus 3. So we can actually just take the last term of this. The first term will be d to the power of 4. The second term will be d and d square, that is d cube. Third term will be 9 by 4 d square, and d square term will add with the d square term from here, and that can be applied on this. Otherwise, this first square d to the power of 4 term need not be taken, because d to the power of 4 applied on x square will give 0. So we'll do that very slowly. This is equal to half 1 minus d square minus 3d by 2. We need not disturb this term, but we will break this plus 1 quarter. First term is d to the power of 4, which we ignore, because d to the power of 4 applied on x square, as we said, will be 0. Second term will be 2 into 3d into d square, that is the d to the power of 3 term. D to the power of 3 term operating on a square function will be again 0. But we of course need to retain 1 by 4 into 9 d square. This term has to be retained, and this is to be applied on x square plus 3. This is equal to half times, let us do the operations. 1 into x square plus 3 is nothing but x square plus 3. Minus half. D square operating on x square plus 3 d square operating on x square plus 3 is d square operating on x square and d square operating on 3. The second operation is 0, but d square operating on x square is, the first operation will be 2x and the second operation will be just 2. So 2. D square operating on x square plus 3. This half is captured here. Minus 3d operating on x square will be minus 6x. 3d is 2x, so 2 minus 6x. This is the second one, plus 1/4 of 9, d square operating on this will be first 2x, then 2, so 1/4, 18. I hope it is all right. The last fellow is now 1/4 outside, plus 9, d square on x square is 2, 9 to the 18, that's fine. So we'll club all this and see this is half. X square 3 plus 3 minus 1 plus 6x plus 18/4, 9/2. This itself is now half of x square plus 6x, and let us see what happens here. 3 minus 1 is 2, 2 plus 9/2 is 13/2. All this leads to x square by 2 plus 3x plus 13/4. So this is our particular integral. But we will get home, that means we will be able to close this chapter only after we verify that this particular integral, yp, indeed does satisfy the equation. In other words, if the original operator d square minus 3d plus 2 operates on this and leads to x square plus 3, which was the function on the right, then we are home. Otherwise, we are not home at all. So we will try to do that. We will operate the fd function, that is, in this case, d square minus 3d plus 2 on this particular function and see if we get x square plus 3. So we'll put the question in a different way.